These windows could shatter to the ground. These walls could fall right down. The lights could open now, because this house is not my home. Crumble into dust. I don't need that much. I don't need that.
Hard to leave.
I can't cry and drive.
It's okay to cry.
One step forward follows one step backwards. That's what it takes to grow.
We just said goodbye to all the family, which is always really hard.
That was really hard.
Especially when, like, you're moving states. So that was very emotional for everybody. But we're on the road now. We are going to try to get some miles down. Haley, thankfully, is doing so much better today. We're just kind of sitting here like, what just happened? Like, it's a lot to process.
You gotta cry.
Like, it's so much to process. Travis trying to hold in all the tears, and I keep telling him it's okay to cry. It's okay to cry and, like, let your emotions out. We're all crying. It's so happy and sad at the same time. We've had such good memories here. No.
The moment we close the truck and leave, but getting a phone call. But we're gonna try and get some miles under us. I think our ETA is probably gonna be like 2 or 3 in the morning. So
it's gonna be really, really late. Thankfully, Haley is doing so much better today.
That is.
And is feeling like way better. She woke up, was running around, playing, just doing so much better, which made us feel a lot better.
Yeah.
Taking the trip, because if she wasn't doing good, we were gonna try to postpone it a day or two. So thankfully, she's doing better. We're gonna sit here and talk about emotions for the next 2 hours till the stop.
We have to stop that soon. We gotta turn the page. So Tennessee, here we come. Alright guys, we made it to stop number one. We got like 3 hours under our belt. I'm cracking up because Mike and Warden have been in the moving truck with Remy, and she just looks hilarious. They were driving behind us and I can see Remy's head.
This dog is so dumb.
Warden does not like Remy anymore.
No.
I don't think he's a dog guy. They have been in the moving truck, and then we are charging up right now. So far, so good. Super thankful that Mike and Dev came along with us. It is definitely a big blessing. Just the extra hand with the baby, as well as the moving truck, especially on a long drive, to have multiple drivers is a blessing. So we're at a stop here. We're actually like in the middle of nowhere. Sometimes you get lucky and these stops have gas stations and food. This one, I believe they said there's food around the corner. So we're gonna get food, take a little break. We're here for about 30 minutes and then get back on the road. Remember if we shared it, but a few months back, Katie had just gotten a brand new phone, and she was sitting down, Haley was on her lap, and Haley kicked the phone, and it absolutely shattered to pieces, the whole back of the screen, and it had a case on it. Now, I think it was like a cheaper case from Amazon.
Amazon case that did not do its job because it broke, and it had a screen protector. The whole thing just shattered into pieces, and I'd had it for like a week, and I was like, oh no.
All right, so we're about to do something fun. Warden's gonna help me, but we're gonna do a drop test with one of Casetify's impact cases. Now they say it can survive up to an 8-foot drop. So we're gonna put it to the test. You don't have to take my word for it. If it shatters, it's on me. So here we go. Warden's gonna take the camera.
Okay,
wait. Here we go. I'm like 5'11". So you think like right here, Mike? Holy.
You gotta jump in the air and then drop it.
No, this is
no, that's definitely like 8 feet.
This is on asphalt too. So here goes nothing. Oh! Just kidding.
Let's see the phone.
Guys.
Nothing.
Nothing at all. Front and back. I'll even take the case off and show you the actual glass on the phone. Nothing. Perfect. They obviously work, and I'm telling you, they are super great, especially if I have a little kid. Katie and I both have them because Haley will take our phone, kick it around, she'll drop it. She's a baby, like, what do you expect?
They have so many cute cases. This is the one I have right now. I have another one too to switch it out with, but they have cute styles, but you're not sacrificing the safety, so no more broken phones here.
I'm gonna leave a link to Casetify's website in our description. I'm telling you, the peace of mind of knowing that these can survive an 8-foot drop is so, so nice. That was a pretty aggressive drop test too, so you guys can take my word for it when I say this will protect your phone. Go check them out. Are you stretching your legs? Ooh, get it, girl. Rap. Can you say woof woof? Ooh, she got you. Woof 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 woof. Time to get back on the road. Guys, there's a fire up on that mountain. We thought it was controlled at first, but there's no way. You can see the glow all up there. That is terrible. Hopefully everyone got out. It's crazy. We are at stop number 2. Haley just woke up from a nap.
Good morning.
It's kind of raining out here, so we're actually gonna be going inside. It's a comfort inn. Gonna get some legs walking, gonna do some stretching. Mike and Warden are at a gas station like 2 minutes away, so they're gonna meet us here in a second.
That's delicious.
I honestly think we're about halfway there.
Whoop whoop! Feels like it's midnight and it's only 8.
I guess we're more than halfway there.
You stole my chips.
Uh-huh.
I just got those out.
What if I drive the moving truck for a little bit? You sure?
We're comfortable.
The Tesla's a lot more comfortable. The dog makes it hot in there?
Yeah, hey, he has the windows fogged up.
The windows did fog
up. I've been freezing. They said they have not had the heat on once, and it's like 30 degrees.
Remy's window was like completely not even see-through.
Yeah,
like,
see-through. I had to put the frost on.
Anyway, we're talking about maybe switching up the seating arrangements, but Mike doesn't want to switch up. He's just a trooper. I know his back's got to be just killing. They said those seats are like cardboard.
No,
why don't
like
you
bricks.
Switch with me?
I just got another energy drink, so now I'm ready to go.
That doesn't help your back.
The seats are like bricks.
Nothing's gonna help my back.
That's terrible. Katie actually drove a little bit on the last stretch. Is this our last stop?
No, I think there's one more.
Well, it could be for us, not for you.
Yeah, this is your second charging stop.
You guys gotta stop with us.
You said
we work as a unit.
We have 400 miles.
Anyway, one more stop. We're getting there.
Why are you laughing like that?
Okay. All right, wait, I gotta restart it. Guys, okay, so I'm doing this, I'm posting this video of Remy driving down, and I did this song on the road again, but it is so funny because it's actually true, because it's like on the road again, going places that I've never been. Wait till you hear it, it's so good.
Going places that I've never been, seeing things that I
made. We got some rain coming in. You can't touch
that. She found something
sweetie.
That made a noise. This one's for you. This one's for you. Look, you want blue? Blue. Color with blue.
Guys, we finally made it to Tennessee. Remy and Izzy.
Finally meet.
Yeah, they're making, whoa, easy. They're becoming friends.
Everyone get 8 hours of sleep and then get up, fresh day, start going. That way everyone's not like wrecked after this long drive. Thank you for letting us crash at your house. You guys are great.
A lot of Katie's family is not even in town. So I think Carlin and Evan get back around 3. So we'll be sure to meet up with some of them, I'm sure, at some point. But
right now, we're just going to bed.
We are a few minutes away from our new home. That sounds like so crazy to say, but we're almost there. Trav's gonna run in, do all the paperwork, get the keys, all of the business stuff. And then we're gonna go in and check it out. Actually though, this one that we actually have, the new apartment, it's a different layout than the one we toured. So we don't really know what to expect. I'm sure it'll be similar because it's the same complex, but like the layout and everything
is different. We were told it's gonna be better, so.
Better.
It's gonna be exciting to check it out.
I'm actually really excited. Okay, we are pulling in. That's crazy.
of power. Okay. That is a relief. I hooked up the account like 2 months ago.
You're running around? Jeez. This is your new home. New home. Do you want to come look? This is Jimmy's new home. Yay! Yeah. But our cousin. What is this?
Closet.
That's nice. Our king size bed would have never fit in here. I'm sorry, would have never fit in here.
Yeah, this is definitely smaller.
Like a dresser won't fit in here.
Let's fill this thing up. The truck is unloaded. Zach came over, was a big help. Warden, Mike, truck is officially empty, guys. So now the real work begins. We said that was the easy part. Now we have to unbox all these boxes, which is probably gonna take at least a week, a month, Warden said. The girls are actually getting ready to run to the Bait Sisters boutique. Zach's gonna take my sister-in-law, Devin, over there and check it out. So good things are happening. We're getting stuff done. And then actually Michael flies out tonight, which really stinks, but they were such a big blessing driving down here and everything. So we're gonna wrap this up, try to spend some time with them before they head out. Zach's the man. All right, just got back from the airport, and these guys are already unpacking the entire place.
Hey, yo. Literally are beasts. Carlin's already got the bathrooms done, most of the nursery done, and now we're working on the kitchen. She says we're gonna have it done in like 2 hours.
That would be insane.
I was thinking like days.
We're gonna try to get as much done as we can. I'm making a list right now of things to grab. We're gonna get some light bulbs because for some reason, they have like 4 different colored lights in the apartment. You got yellow, white, and blue. So we're gonna run to Walmart, grab that, and then come back and try to work on a little bit of that. But we do have church tomorrow, so not doing anything crazy late tonight, but we wanna get a lot done, and so far, it's going really well. One thing we're super happy about is this apartment layout came with a garage. And when we originally found out we were getting an apartment, it was not this layout. They called us like 3 weeks later and we're like, hey, we have an opportunity to move in at the end of March. It's a slightly different layout, but it has a garage. And it was only like $100 extra a month, I think. And we got this whole garage. And also it was a blessing because we have the Tesla, which is an electric car, and there's an outlet in here. Now it won't be super fast charging, but it's better than nothing. I think it's great, especially with the baby, if it's raining or something like that. And it's pretty spacious. You got the garage. We still have a lot of stuff in here, obviously. And then they have a little ledge right here where we could put storage. I'm actually gonna add that to my list. Maybe grab that from Lowe's or Walmart, but get some shelving so we can organize this, get it all set up. So that's really nice because space in an apartment is already, you know, an issue and somewhat tight. So this helped out a lot, which is a big, big blessing. We're gonna be figuring stuff out for probably like a couple weeks on what works or doesn't. But day one, it's going good so far. Time to go to bed, okay? Time to go to bed. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, pray to give Haley a good night's sleep. Pray to help her to get all rested up for church tomorrow. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. All right, babe, give us your first impressions. You've been here for like, well, 24 hours, but in the apartment for 12. Mm. How you feeling?
I don't even know. Like, it's hard to process all of the emotions that are going into this, from a crazy travel trip and then unpacking, packing, like all of that just feels so like unreal. When we actually walk in, I'm like, is this our home? And part of it doesn't really feel like a home yet, but as we are unpacking and getting stuff done, like the bathrooms, some of the kitchen is starting to feel more like that. I think tonight is going to be the craziest night just because it's like, what are we doing? I don't know how I'm going to sleep right now. Like, I'm amped up on energy and I'm excited.
She's been working like crazy. I had to tell her to stop so we can put the baby to bed.
There's so much to do. I want to do it all while I can. And I just needed a clear walking path first so I could get from there to the bedroom and like walk around. And tomorrow's Sunday, so I'm going to pick all the Sunday outfits. I packed in a suitcase for a week and forgot about Sunday. So I'm going through, like, rummaging through all of the boxes, trying to find stuff for our outfits. Haley's in them too. Say, I'm excited, Dad. We're having a midnight snack of crunchies. The best.
Getting this place to feel like home is something that will help a lot because I'm gonna be honest, apartment living, it just the 12 hours I've been here is something that is gonna take a lot to adjust to. Katie was laughing at me earlier, but there's people like right outside our window, walking dogs, there's cars everywhere.
I think part of it is Remy goes crazy when she hears people like outside, and so we know that they're there, and it's more of a mental thing, like we're not actually seeing them, but Remy knows they're there, it gets a little crazy.
We got home from dinner, and all of a sudden we hear this noise, and we both looked at each other, and then we're like, that's just somebody like in the breezeway walking by.
I thought a TV was playing.
We didn't even say anything, we just laughed, but you know, it's a very nice apartment, so nothing against apartments. I feel like we got really blessed with a great community. Even people were already saying hi. It's just gonna take a lot of adjusting and getting used to. So we're up for the challenge. Haley and Remy are doing great as well. I was a little nervous with the big change with Remy, making sure she wasn't gonna be too stressed out, but she seems to be doing okay. It's definitely gonna be a big change for her. Even going outside, using the bathroom, she's used to just going outside by herself. Now we're doing the leash walking, which is gonna be fun for us both at 6:30 in the morning, but it's okay. Haley is having fun. She is being a crazy.
She's exploring non-stop.
I know she's young, but it's still a big adjustment. So both of us want to make it feel like a home and like a normal place as soon as possible.
Make so many memories. Just get started. When you walk in the door, we want it to feel like home and very cozy. I think even more so because it's an apartment and there's people around and all that. So we just want to make it really cozy.
It has been a crazy 24 hours. We got a lot done. We're super happy. We are exhausted though.
Yes.
So we're gonna be going to bed. We have church tomorrow. It is Palm Sunday. And then Easter's the next week. So two great weeks back to back. But we've got a lot to do. We've got a lot of furniture to order, a lot of things to unpack still. And we're looking forward to seeing Katie's family. They're currently out of town. So, hey, it's okay.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
We've had so much help getting to this point. People helping us in New Jersey move, people helping us in Tennessee move, so we're super thankful to everyone who's helped us. That is gonna wrap up this week's video. First night in Tennessee.
I don't think I'm gonna be able to sleep tonight. I'm just being honest, like I don't know how I'm gonna sleep. When I sleep in new places already, I get like a little bit
just awake insomnia. Tonight, though, babe. I'm like wired.
I'm gonna be out like a light. I'm sorry. Katie's gonna be like, Trav.
No, he falls asleep in like 2 seconds, and I'm gonna be up like 3 hours, like contemplating everything that's going on and trying to process. All good, though. We better get to bed now because it's gonna be real late.
Thanks for watching, guys. We really appreciate it. Thanks for all the kind words. We will be sure to keep you updated, and we will see you next time. Peace out.